We want to determine the area under the piecewise defined function given here on the closed interval from 1 to 6. So here's x equals 1, and here's x equals 6. We want to determine the area bounded by the function in the x-axis, or the shaded region here. And this problem is a little bit different than the previous examples because the area is bounded by the red line from 1 to 4, and then from 4 to 6 it's bounded by the blue line. But since the function is non-negative on the interval from 1 to 6, we can still use definite integrals to determine this area, but now we'll have to use two different definite integrals to determine the total area. The first definite integral will be from 1 to 4, and on this interval, the area is bounded by the red line, which is 2x plus 1 when x is less than or equal to 4. But then we'll also have to integrate from 4 to 6 using the second function of 13 minus x with respect to x. So the sum of these two definite integrals will give us the total area in green. So the antiderivative of 2x would be 2 times x squared divided by 2, or x squared, plus x. We'll evaluate this at 4 and 1, plus the antiderivative of 13 minus x would be 13x minus x squared divided by 2. We'll evaluate this at 6 and 4. So replacing x with 4, we're going to have 16 plus 4, that's 20. Minus replacing x with 1, we'd have 1 squared plus 1, or 2. Plus, here we'll replace x with 6 first, so we'll have 13 times 6 minus 6 squared divided by 2. Well, 13 times 6 would be 78, minus 36 divided by 2, that's going to be minus 18. So that'll be 60, minus 13 times 4 minus 4 squared divided by 2. Well, 13 times 4 is 52, and then 52 minus, this will be 16 divided by 2, or minus 8. That'll give us 44. So we'll have 18 plus 16, which will give us 34 square units for the area of this green shaded region. Now notice the region on the left and the right are trapezoids, so we could have used the area formula for a trapezoid, but we wanted to use calculus techniques to determine this area. I hope you found this helpful.